Bye. it? It's over?
I'd like to welcome everybody to my channel this week. My name is BrownMark, and we're breaking down simple funk. This week I chose five-note funk. And I took it back to mid-70s into the 80s. I remember when Ohio, Detroit, these cities started coming on the map, and it was this very simple funk. I call it five-note funk. I picked three songs that had just five notes, basic notes, that were just funky. And then the way that they intertwined with the guitar, I mean, it was just, you know, iconic. So I started out with Steve Arrington, and man, I remember when I first heard that track, you know, that was a little newer than some of the other two tracks. They're a little older, but I remember when Steve Arrington came out with Weekend of Needs, man, that was the joint. So I'm breaking that down for you. And then I'm breaking down Bustin Loose. I was young when Bustin Loose came out, but man, Rick James changed the game. You know, there was a time period when jazz was moving into funk, so everything was more slap funk. But right in that same time, I mean, Ohio was coming in on the map, and man, with Slave and Son and all these cats. And let me tell you something, that simple funk is something to it. And that's why I wanted to break it down. You don't have to, you know, be all technical and do all these fancy licks and be funky. You can keep it simple and your joint will be, you know, on fire. So we're going to break down Bustin' Loose, and then we're going to go into the iconic Flashlight. Everybody knows that. That's some unspeakable Parliament-Funkadelic funk right there. So we're going to break it down. Real basic, not a lot to it. You know, of course, I added my own little thing to it. But I'm just trying to teach y'all how to take a simple song, throw a little groove on it. When you're playing live, that's what you want to do. Don't just play it like the record. Put your own thing on it, man. The audience will enjoy that, and that's what gets people into it. So we're going to start with Weak at the Knees. Check this out. So as you can see, Weak at the Knees plays along with the guitar. Man, I don't know who came up with that. I don't know if it was Steve Arrington or whoever the guitar player was. That was funky. The way the bass kind of lined with the guitar, yeah. I like doing stuff like that even to this day, because that had a major impact on me. But you notice how simple it is. So I'm going to show you right now how simple that bass line is. Check this out. Five notes. One, E, two, three, four, and then five. That's all the notes there are to this song. Five notes. So that brings us to Bustin' Out by Rick James. Whew! Five notes of just funk. He put the envelope filter or something on it, whatever pedal he was using. I just used the Qtron. That's my favorite pedal right now. Walk. results are A, C, G, back to a C, open A, to a D. So you notice with Rick James, five notes, that's all I'm hitting. And you could just hear how funky it is, because all the other instruments, there's room for everybody to breathe. So he just keeps it simple. And that's the key to this video. I want to show people how to keep it simple and allow other musicians to breathe, other instruments to breathe within the cohesion, you know, the band's cohesiveness. So we're going to move on to flashlight. You're going to notice with flashlight, it's a similar thing, only there's a synth bass. When you add synth bass, you got to stay out of his way. You got to let the synthesizer breathe. If he has the main part and you're a bass player and you just don't want to stand on stage doing anything. So I use this technique where I showed it last week when we did the how to make a groove in 5 minutes, where I just take the palm of my hand and I just lay it on the strings and I use my thumb, and then it creates this muted technique. That's always good for when you have a synthesized bass player that has the lead part, like in Flashlight. So notice what I do with flashlight. We're starting on a C to a B flat, G walk down to the F. That's all it is. That way you stay out of the way of the synth bass. I don't even do the walk up. I just go. Let the synth breathe. That's all it is. So there you see it, flashlight, five notes. And see how funky that is. Yeah, I use my fuzz pedal. I started getting into some other stuff, but you know, that's just putting your own personality into the feel of the song. But as you can see, that groove is just basic. There's nothing really to it. And so that's the whole exercise this week. I want everyone to just grab your bass, pick a song, even if it's these three songs, and just try to go outside of the box a little bit, but keep it simple. Try to do it without getting in the way of some of the other instruments, some of the other players. Try that. That's all I have for you this week. I am going to start making available backing tracks for musicians, and they're going to be funky. It's going to have all the grooves that you see me doing. I'm going to put them in a backing track format, and that's going to be available soon. I'll let you guys know when I have that complete. But that's it for this week. Hope I see you next week. And don't forget, subscribe to this channel. Let's keep it growing. Tell your friends about it. Tell all your musician friends. Even tell the youngsters about it. We're trying to get this new generation to bring back some of this old school funk, because, man, you can't tell me it don't make your head snap. You know, it be making me want to just like, hey, I'm going to have a little party. What? So, hey, that's it. I'll see you next week.